Anyway, this definitely is a woman snaring bachelor pad, fully loaded to get you in the mood.
Are you in the mood, Sip?
Yes, Barbara. I am. No? After you've waited all this time and now you're saying no?
Yes. There's something I want to tell you.
Oh, no. Yes, Barbara Novak? Tell me anything.
I love you.
Tell me how much, Barbara Novak.
Too much. Oh, too much. Too much to have sex with you.
All right, because you are Barbara Novak. Author of Down with Love. And you do not believe in having sex with feelings.
No, that's not why I want you to stop. I want you to stop because I love you too much to have sex without marrying you. I want what every woman wants, love and marriage. I'm not a Down with Love girl. I'm not the girl you think I am.
Oh, you are exactly the girl I think you are.
Leaving a key on the outside when you're busy on the inside. Oh, why the long faces. We're all equal, self-reliant citizens of the world here. I know I am, and heaven knows all men are. And you're with Catch Block, so I certainly hope you are. Anyway, I just popped by for a little sex a la carte. But since you're busy, I'll just ring up my crew captain at the hotel. Cheerio.
All right. Now you know. I'm Katja Block. Not Sip Martin. There is no Sip Martin. But before you storm out of here, admit it. I got you. I got Barbara Down with Love Novak to fall in love.
I'm not gonna storm out of here, Catch. And I'm not gonna admit that you got Barbara Novak to fall in love. Because I'm not Barbara Novak. There is no Barbara Novak.
Huh?
And I didn't fall in love with Sip Martin. I fell in love with Catcher Block. And that was a year ago, when for 3.5 weeks I worked as your secretary. I don't expect you to remember me, I wasn't a blonde then. But you did ask me out, and it broke my heart to say no. But I loved you too much. I couldn't bear to become just another notch in your bedpost. With your dating habits, I knew that even if I was lucky enough to get a regular spot on your rotating schedule, I would never have your undivided attention long enough for you to fall in love with me. I knew I had to do something to set myself apart. I knew I had to quit my job as your secretary and write an international bestseller, controversial enough to get the attention of a New York publisher, as well as No Magazine, but insignificant enough that as long as I went unseen, No Magazine's star journalist would refuse to do a cover story about it. I knew that every time we were supposed to meet, you would get distracted by one of your many girlfriends and stand me up, and this would give me a reason to fight with you over the phone and declare that I wouldn't meet with you for 100 years. And then all I would have to do was be patient and wait the 2 or 3 weeks it would take for everyone in the world to buy a copy of my bestseller. And then I would begin to get the publicity I would need for you to, one, see what I look like, and two, see me denounce you in public as the worst kind of man. I knew that this would make you want to get even by writing one of your exposés. And in order to do that, you would have to go undercover, assume a false identity, and pretend to be the kind of man who would make the kind of girl I was pretending to be fall in love. I knew that since I was pretending to be a girl who would have sex on the first date, you would have to pretend to be a man who wouldn't have sex for several dates. And in doing so, we would go out on lots of dates to all the best places and all the hit shows. Until finally, one night, you would take me back to your place that you were pretending was someone else's in order to get the evidence you needed to write your exposé by seducing me until I said I love you. But saying I love you was also my plan. I just wanted to tell you the truth so that when you heard me say I love you, you would know that I knew who you were and you would know who I was. Then you, the great Catcher Block, would know that you'd been beaten at your own game. By me, Nancy Brown, your former secretary, and I would have once and for all set myself apart from all the other girls you've known. All those other girls that you never really cared about, by making myself someone like the one person you really love and admire above all others, you. And when you realized that you had finally met your match, I would have at last gained the respect that would make you want to marry me first and seduce me later. I just wanted you to hear all of this from me before you heard it from your private eye.
Yeah.
Look, McNulty. Got everything there is on Novak, and it's nothing. Novak doesn't exist, except for a P.O. box in Maine in care of one Nancy Brown of 28 Gramercy Park, where she was born and raised. And while our Nancy may have broken a few hearts growing up, I can't find the guy we're looking for, broke her.
Never mind. I found him.